first of all, a little introduction. You know, in our school is not only the school, but in our buildings, you know, it's not only the school, but it's also the headquarters of Central and East European Management Development Association. Also, seven Romanian schools are a member. That is the association that I built 20 years ago. School is 29 years old. But 20 years ago, 21 already in the meantime, I saw that you are nobody, you know, coming from a socialist country, coming from a country where we didn't have management, coming from a country which is 2 million inhabitants, nobody ever heard of it, you know, or only some in the world. I saw that I have to do something and that we have to start to communicate among ourselves. So I established it. 12-13 was one Romanian, Gabriel Mazzavan, if you know him. He was my first supporter from Romania, a really big supporter. And so we created this association, CEE Men, which today we are thinking whether we will change the name, because today we have 217 business schools from 54 countries, so it's not anymore Central Eastern Europe. We are now changing more to dynamic societies, to the quickly developed societies, you know, where 80% emerging economies, where 80% of the people are living, and where, and because we are having a little bit enough, why should Americans and others who have 100 years of management education set, you know, their standards of quality on us, you know, impose them on us and let them believe that how much you earn is the most important when you graduate the MBA, for how many multinationals they are, who are working, etc. So in this association we have also an academy for teaching teachers, and more than 500 people graduated already. And every June we have this academy, and we have also research. And we came to the idea that we would like to put the countries, the innovative companies and the countries, you know, where these innovative companies are, on the map of the world. Because Hermann Simon, a German professor of management, he wrote a book, Hidden Champions, and he gave the definition, what are hidden champions? They are called hidden because almost nobody knows for them. You will check whether you know your hidden champions in Romania. That was one thing. And the other one is that, you know, because they don't like to patent their things, they don't like that they are knowing people for them. And so he was trying to show that Germany is a successful economy because it has such a big strength in medium size and small size economy, where, you know, which are worldwide innovative. So, and then I knew him for many years. He was a dean of the business school in that time in Cologne when we met 23-24 years ago. And so I asked him whether he would give us his methodology, and he gave. And then we started to discover our own innovative company in this part of the world. And we published a book. It was an idea that we would also have it in Kazakhstan, because through this association of business schools from 54 countries, we have a big reach to researchers, you know, to people who can make a research. If you go to different international conferences, you will see how they are interested in that, because they can't make, you know, research in 18 countries. We did it in 18 countries. Then book was published only about 15 countries because not all of them really performed. Some researchers were not really enough serious. So we threw out the last moment Kazakhstan because they didn't want to correct some mistakes and we couldn't wait anymore. It was already 4 years that we were doing. So some things are not actual anymore. And that's why I asked Bogdan Rusu from Iași University, that he of technology, who was a researcher for Romania, that he is updating me, and he did it last 2 days. So let's go to see now. So you see here, and here is our street. Not bad. Every morning you can go and run around the lake. And there is a castle. Sirap is a castle 1,000 years old. In 2004, when Slovenia joined the European Union, it was 1,000 years old. And in 2007, when we got Europe, you know, we made the international conference Bleed to Europe, Europe to Bleed. Because we said, why should we run to Europe? Europe should come to us. So, here it is. You see, Hermann Simon said that in champions are the companies that are one, two, or three in the global market. You see? So, and then you see further, or one in Europe, and then we added on our own. We said, but also Central Eastern Europe is half a million of inhabitants. So why shouldn't we also consider as number one in this part of the world? And they had revenues less than 3 billion, and people don't know for that because they don't want that people know for that. So we were interested in, and as I said, we added also Turkey. No, this is not Central Eastern Europe, but we added it because we see how Turkey is a strong economy, strong country, and also because we had from the Danish University a very strong research team. Probably the best. And that's why, since we cooperate with Samanji, is our member, etc., we were allowing them to enter, and I think that we made a big favor. And then we went to Vienna. And this is what I would suggest to you the same. You know, we went to Vienna in 2011 to have a conference there, and we were last week having a conference there presenting this book, because to Vienna, you know, Vienna is hub. People for the airplanes, etc., people, you know, it's easy to access Vienna, and so we had a lot of journalists there, a lot of publicity, etc., and we made it this time, last time together with Chamber, and this time together with the Wirtschaft University, with the Economic University of Vienna, so that we were really, you know, having a win-win situation, getting a lot of people together. So these are, what are the general characteristics? These are fast-growing companies. They are not, you know, they are not, they have one problem. They are so much investing in people and especially research that they are, when I say people, it means that they are getting the best Americans in the field, the best, you know. When they hear that there is somebody very good, they are bringing them there. And people like it. When Ian Sutherland heard that we are dealing with art and leadership and he is interested in it, he came from Canada to live in Slovenia. People go there where they see the possibility for their development of their talents and that they can do what they like to do. And so they were, and they have a problem with financing. They are, because they are investing everything you pay in the research, in the further development, you know. So these are not too rich companies, and they are constantly walking on the edge. Some of them are. But like Akrapovic, did you hear for Akrapovic? Slovenian firm, Akrapovic, I was not in Colombia, and I told you letters of the shop written Akrapovic, he is making the best exhaust pipes, Ausflug, you say in German, you know, for the motors, because he was a biker himself. And he saw Akrapovic, Mr. Akrapovic, and he saw that this is terribly important, and he started to make the number one exhaust pipes in the world. And you know, and that's why I say they are all the time investing, and that's why they have all the time problems with money. That's why the countries, the government should a little bit support them, because these guys can really develop and create thousands and thousands of new cases. They have a low level, you know, they are not so sensitive to the crisis. You didn't see any of these companies that would fail. One of the main companies, Hidria, which was last year chosen as the number one innovative company in whole Europe, and that's a big company with some thousands of employees. They had some problems because of the loans, but you know, being the most innovative in Europe, government should support them immediately. You know, government, the bank giving them the proper loan so that they could, you know, come out of the crisis. But in general, they are not sensitive on recession, and they are gaining new and new markets. In spite of that, they are independent of national markets, and they are highly focused, and they are very much customer-oriented. this is unbelievable. You know, I went to visit a company in Slovenia, and I mean, I had to visit all of them. But once I remember how it was, you know, especially I like to remember the which is called instrumentation technologies. What are they doing? They make the accelerators, Libera is the name of their product, accelerators, and these accelerators are will be very, very important in medicine, because they are pushing the, you know, when you have a radiation, if you have a cancer, you have a, you have to have a chemotherapy or radiation. And then what happens with radiation is that it's spoiling you all the organs till it comes to the tumor. And now they have such an accelerator that it grows so quickly that it's exactly stopping there where it's necessary at the tumor and not spoiling and disturbing and destroying all other everything else. So this, I came to visit them, and the general manager and the owner of that company, he said, he is like in a small village on the border of Italy, and he said to me that he has only 10-15 minutes time to talk, because he established the orchestra, and he has only 50 people, and he established the orchestra after he discovered that everybody plays an instrument, and they will have a lunch together to discuss how they will start playing to have fun in that So they really create a special atmosphere, and they are really very, very much reactive from customers. You can have hidden chambers that are in mature niches, you know, like in textile, like in IT, like in industrial equipment, content, etc. Or you can have just somebody that I mentioned now in nanotechnology and so on. So that they are really, you know, in some very innovative biotechnology, etc. They are in the top of the top. And ecologically advanced. This is also very important. They have a special attitude to ecology. The growth strategies, they are, integrating this independent, you know, the equipment parts that they are making into their own branding. They are integrating into services. They have innovative products and business models. Here we have today competing Studio Moderna, which is headquartered having in Slovenia, but it's, I think, in 21 countries. And Studio Moderna is an innovator worldwide in the business model, not in the product, but in the business model. And that's why they are also one of the hidden champions. And they are, of course, and they see that it's somebody else are very much deep. They are stopping usually, you know, in their products and going quickly opening some new niche there. They are, and now I have some info concerning leadership, concerning customers, concerning different segments. They are, how long they behave. They are serving the most demanding customers. They are capable to make the best solutions possible. That's why, you know, Siemens, you know, them and engage them. Like Optotec, the Norwegian lens, number one in the world, lens company was bought by Japanese company. And, you know, they are, when we were first time in 2011 in Vienna, there were 9 Chinese coming. And we asked, what are you doing? You're not coming to Vienna. They said, we came whether we can buy some of these companies. Usually they don't want to sell it, but here and there it happens. So hidden champions are also very good in educating the guys who are their distributors. So they are really everything doing on a very high level so that nobody is surprised. And they are, of course, customers hire them to help them to find the solution and ability to see the future, you know, because they are really having a strong imagination on the basis of what they are doing, and they are well known because they are in their profession, they are receiving many international prizes. But again, they would hardly publish them. I didn't know, I knew 2 or 3
hidden gem. Slovenia has, for instance, Seaway. This is the maybe the most beautiful yacht launch in the world. Then you have a couple which I mentioned already, the exhaust pipes. Then you have Pipistrel. Pipistrel is maybe the lightest planes in the world. And now we moved to Italy, it was part of the production, because you know it is now better. The Chinese wants to expand. And you know what we do? Also on the history of energy, you know that we are flying on. So it's constantly innovating and constantly being on this. So these three I knew. I knew for a couple because it has 700 people in front of it. I knew for Seaway because it's every year getting the prizes everywhere, every year they are number one in the world. And you know who makes them? He is a doctor of cardiology, specialist on cardiology, and he makes this work. He designs this course, and he's a doctor of cardiology. Very funny. His brother is architect, and the author of that, the architect, is the one who is a cardiologist and makes this fantastic. But then we have another 13-14 in Slovenia that I never heard of them. And only when we started to check and to look around, we discovered that the best for cutting wood, you know, the best, how do you call that, machines for cutting wood? Yeah, you have to know your English sewing machines, you know, is a Slovene who is competing with Finland, and that is in the small Slovenian village who is making them. So these are the really fantastic innovative companies. And you know, concerning employees and ownership, they are, many of them are family companies, but you know, some are not. As I mentioned, one of them became now the hands of Japanese and some others. So they are, you know, but usually the owners have quite a big stake in them. And they are serving their employees, they are highly committed to the company. I was mentioning already, you know, they are really living for the company. Usually, you know, if you look to your company, it's one or two or three who are, you know, devoted and totally committed. But there you can see 50 people who are, you know, really heroes, you know, service heroes or workers heroes. They are really believing in what the company is doing. And I mentioned already, they don't like too much the external financing, and they have quite some succession problem. We are now looking to these stories, and just the man that I mentioned with the wood, you know, wood processing, cutting wood, each logs, you know. He explained his story at one of our events, how he wanted to know, his father was the one who was the owner, and his father wanted to stay in Slovenia. And he said, no, I don't out to China for this and that, come to Canada and so on. And then he went to tell the company with his father, because his father said, you will destroy the company. I don't believe him. He spent like 600,000. Great business in the market, and it was a business, but his father didn't know what to take risk. So they are cleaning nicely, you see. Multitasking is great. So you know, we have plenty of stories with these people, how difficult it is. We were now having together 17 hidden checkers, but two of them. Where one of them was from Belarus, and he came with his daughter. And his daughter is interested in languages, in Slavic languages, and she was translating the father. And then I said, because he speaks Russian, although he tries to learn English, and he has business already now in Brazil, and he is the number one in all Eastern Central Europe in painting the roads, you know, painting the white paint, you know. And he is also, Steam is the name of the company. And he is also producing the machines to paint them. You know, he has 600 people in the meantime in Florida. So his daughter was a translator. Then another company, Doc Inc. from Croatia, dealing with mines, with helping to eliminate the mines. And you know that Bosnia has
millions of lights still, you know, and the mine is costing €5 to produce it, and it's costing €20,000 to eliminate it. So it's terrible. And now you saw on television these waters, how this terrible floods. You know, the mines are going with this flood now, and they start to explode, and it's not under control anymore, because before you knew exactly, it was clean, and there was a red rope, and there is not clean. And now, in this rivers, terrible, big rivers now, all this, not all, but many of these mines are going further now. And so her father started this company, and the daughter is now taking over. She has a Master of Science in Economics. She is now a member of the board already, and she is helping to the father. And I ask her, how is it with your father, etc. She says, he's very stubborn, he doesn't want to do what I ask him, etc. But still, they are quite, you know, working nicely together. So that we have a lot of stories how, you know, the younger generation is more professional, less emotional, less charisma, having seen different way of managing the company. So that is one of the serious problems, and I think that in that chapter, which was contributed by Ian, Ian, I should be very happy if you are, when I come to leadership, adding something, because he did that, he was adding, contributing to the group, the chapter on leadership. You know? So, what is, here we are, leadership. So, perhaps you can just say something.
Across the hidden champions companies, leadership was said one of the key success factors for companies. They tended to be founded by singular individuals who then spent a long tenure as CEOs, presidents of those companies. Some of them now are still in those positions, so succession planning, as the board mentioned, is a challenge right now. Some of them have already left the companies. But there are quite a lot of similarities across the kind of leadership that we're finding, that you can see them on the screen there. People with strong vision, strong personalities, charismatic, very caring. But one of the core things that I was able to have across them was the sense of what I called in the chapter the community ship. I'm actually worried that Henry Mintz work as a management scholar based in Canada. They were individuals that didn't set out to create companies purely based on profit of the resources they had, but they wanted to create communities of people that were part of, cared for, and belonged to something bigger than themselves. And that is found very much present in these characteristics, holistic leadership, seeing the entire company, thinking very strategically all the time of what's going to benefit not just myself, but our employees and the wider communities, the towns, the states, the regions around them. They have this very, very impressive ethical, moral look to how things are working out. There's a lot more on leadership I'd be happy to talk to you about in the dinner or after.
Thank you very much. You know, he mentioned Henry Mintzberg, and he exactly quoted, in fact, he quoted him. Henry Mintzberg is one of the top people in the world for organizational behavior, a Canadian at McGill University, and he use the same words. Community ship is when the people are thinking, the leaders are thinking about something else and only about themselves. And that is, you know, community ship is his expression, and you will meet that more often. Because we are really very much talking in leadership about that, how leaders should look further than just their own company or their own pocket. You know? And here you can see that. This total commitment to the organization, to the company, to environment, sustainability, you know, and they are acting as responsible citizenship. They are really doing the things that are friendly, you know, to the nature. And of course, profit is important, but it's not what the company is. If you ask them, why are you doing all that? Why are you for years day and night working? They are mostly saying because of passion. Because I believe I can do something for the society, I can do something for the country, I can do something for the world, etc. They are
beyond the borders looking, and not just, you know, in that little circle around that. There are innovation, you know, there are, as I mentioned already, but I will hear the chapters. So they are very, very important innovators. They are close to the customers. They are trying to understand the needs of the customers and then to innovate for them. They are, of course, you know this expression, open innovation. You know it? It's Henry Chesbrough. If somebody is interested in innovation, then you have a book, Open Innovation, of Henry Chesbrough. And if you are very much interested in it and you don't want to go to look for that book, then you just write in that paper that I gave you outside. He would send me the book or just say, Open Innovation. Because we had invited him 2 years ago to lecture, and he published his lecture, and I still have quite some books, and I can send you the book on open innovation. That is, you know, when you are, you know, not, Henry Chesbrough is saying, not every innovation is in your company getting realization. Because some companies have too many innovations. And some companies don't have any, but they have capacity to innovate. So he is promoting that you are, you know, taking from somewhere, that you are eager to share this innovation with other people and you give them. And you are constantly looking for some innovation and integrating them in your system. Like he said to me, your CMAT, your Association of Management Schools, is an open innovation, Professor said. He said, because you saw that you are not enough important as a school. So you, and not only me, but I saw how Eastern Central Europe was fighting for recognition. And he said, and then you invited, invented something good, which gave you a big strength. And then everybody has to respect you today with 217 business schools. No? It's not only one little school that you are walking around. So that's why this open innovation is, you know, they are integrated in. In if they see something that would be good for them. Commercialization innovations, they are trying to do it, not only to dream about, but to use it, and then you get innovation from invention. And then, you know, leaders' role. Leaders are driving innovations. That, you know, the top guy is really important, and I mentioned this already, that they are not so eager to make patents. You know why not? Do you imagine why they don't want to innovate capital? Because it goes too slow. They are already inventing something new before this is patented. You know, this is the main reason. It's so quickly going that nobody can catch it. All the time something new. We have also a management education, we have a school in Croatia, constantly copying us. Even the phrase, I have a special phrase in Slovene, in English is not at all. Something special, but in Slovene was kind of very nice sounding words, very cordial, and now this Croatian school started to take it over from us. And then somebody said, you know, I said, oh, it doesn't matter, they forced me to make something new, another one, and another one, another one. In fact, you know, such a mimicking and a copying all the time, it drives you just, you know, it drives you, so that you are all the time innovating, all the time getting better. So here are hidden champions in Romania. There are more. I wrote myself here down. There are more than that. I have three. Description of three. I shall tell you what Bogdan was this morning. Romanian guy sent it to me, and he said that some of them were, when they became, seen, they were buying them. And I shall tell you three of them who were hidden champions, but they were bought very quickly. One of them was Radix, and it was bought by Nest Technology. Do you know it? Anybody knows it? Radix. Then he said they were acquired very quickly by Nest Technology. Then it was Bitdefender. Bitdefender was became very quickly partner of Microsoft. This is the world. So you know Romania invented the world best buy antivirus, antivirus software. It is from, you had the best mathematical school in the world, I remember years ago. So And whenever we got students from your country, they were always the best, you know, in counting and mathematically thinking in the group. We always put one of them in because we knew that it would be very useful. And then you had Walker, Joe, and this was bought by Nestlé. So these were the three hidden champions. And so then our researcher, Bogdan Russo from Yash, he was describing three hidden champions, and here you will see the what is written in the book. And then I asked him now to update, and you will see immediately next to that the update, where they are today. So one is Elekta, and this is the biggest manufacturer of interphone in Romania, spreading abroad, etc. And they were also diversifying to alarm systems. And you can see their revenues, and etc. A number of employees, and that is wrong because they were 500,000. That is the mistake there. They were 500 already. You have a hand there?
Yes.
Do you want to ask them?
Yes. In Romania, we have two antiviruses. One is Romanian antivirus, and it was bought by Microsoft, and another one is Bitdefender, so there are two. So we have another one right now, and it's in, I think they want to be listed or something, but right now they're independent.
Thank you very much. I shall write this down, because what we would like to do is to continue with this research. Now we have something that not very well in the hand, so now it would be really pity to continue and to get more in each other, because I'm sure that Romania has at least 20. Slovenia has 60, you know, but then because of my good connection and because of the school, etc., we were able to discover them. And there are in the meantime two or three more. But here we were dependent on one person. And but 500 of these, there's a typing mistake, and Maria Berdan was the president owner, CEO and founder. And then you had Liga company. So this is the biggest provider of the string musical instruments, and the Liga was I have it here. They were 50% selling to the United States, 25% to Europe, 25%, 10% to Japan, 10% to Australia. So come, it's only 5% states still for the countries like Singapore, Taiwan, and Malaysia, and perhaps a little bit more Romania. So they are also, the Liga is also very much taking care of community. They establish kindergartens and new nurseries. They have dance sport club, and this dance sport, do you know, does anybody know in that company? Yes? Bigger company, and they were receiving many international prizes. I went to read the book still this morning to look at what would be interesting. And they are selling also internet. That was kind of a new thing, you know. And you know what they are able? They are able to make this violin. So they have a violin dance club, you know, like a dancing violin. I don't know whether they are really dancing violin, but they have such a club. And so they are really the number one provider of musical instruments in Europe. So you have a fantastic company in this country, and they are capable. They have some segments like for schools, for individual violin players, and other, you know, who are playing on strings instruments. And they are capable to make on the highest professionals to make this instrument, you know. And they are mostly looking to Stradivari and trying to have this. And why in Romania? Because you have this fantastic wood, which is very important. And the other thing is the expertise of the, you know, some professionals. And then you have a very good company. That is the designer of internet solution for building up clients' identity, recognition, reputation, etc. They were all established, you know, in the beginning of the day after day, working in, for labor costs, this time, on your banks, on the system of the banks, so they started to work on the websites, etc. They are not anymore on that so much, but they are specialized on some how shall I say, product owning, and but they are more working on for ING Bank they work. I saw in the book and it happened the paper that the Bogdan was sending me. It's an Aeon engineer, it's a Renault, and it is ING Bank. These are their very important key clients. This is what I would discover, about them. And I didn't say about the impact of the data. So the data was also making some, they have a little bit of problems with the crisis, but they are today very big exporter to Norway, Germany, and Austria. And
in something, it can be a very much more market niche,
then you absolutely great if you let us know, or if you are by yourself, if some of you are researchers here, interested in cooperating with them, because we could make a big favor to them, to the country, you know, to Romania, to our association to promote them and to make a serious effort on yourself also to keep yourself on the map of the world. So it is a big invitation because we are cannot also in discover the general. And you could see the guy from Yash, you know, he's a professor at the university, he had two companies from Yash. So you have to be closer to them, you have to be close to start to, you know, to smell the. So these are the finish, and thank you very much for your attention.